This is the show with the interesting intro, so I'm gonna try and replicate it like I used to do because I haven't done this for a while. Let's see. Ladies and gentlemen, I've run out of ideas again, which is why this week I'm gonna do another episode of Let's Chat. That's how it usually goes, right? Well, I guess, yeah, that's all we're gonna do this week. I'm just gonna talk a little bit about some of the gadgets that have been pretty significant in my school life. I guess this also ties into some of my previous Let's Chat episodes, so, well, I guess this is a series now. Proper content will return next week, so yeah, let me off for a week. Anyway, more on this after the break.
This is 0612 TV.
Welcome aboard.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Let's Chat. Today, we're gonna talk about my top 3 gadgets that have played a part in my school life. Now, just to be clear, I'm actually excluding my laptop from this entire discussion, seeing as that, well, I mean, that's kinda important thing that everyone already has anyway. Well, not necessarily a laptop, just a computer of some kind. I'm currently using a laptop as my one and only computer. But yeah, we won't factor this in because I expect everyone to have this. So let's talk about the things that are slightly less common. First of the three is actually a portable hard disk, and that is my Western Digital MyPassport, a 1TB USB 3 portable hard disk. Now, I've actually talked a little bit about this particular device before in a previous episode of Let's Chat called My Backup Strategy. At any rate, when you're a student, especially at the university level, what you do is you do a lot of assignments, you do a lot of projects. Especially for me as a computing student, I do a lot of these things on the computer. And what happens is, from time to time, you just get this fear. Like, when you're in the shower, you're thinking about life, and then suddenly it comes to you like, what if my computer breaks and I lose everything? In fact, this really applies to anyone who uses a computer as their main tool for doing their work. You want some means of reassuring yourself that even if your computer breaks or gets stolen or, you know, any other kind of problem happens, you still have your data actually backed up somewhere. And that is when, you know, something like a portable hard disk actually comes into play. As mentioned in the other vlog, what I have is a USB 3 hard disk, which means that backing up things is very quick, it's very easy, and as a result, I do it a lot. The ability to quickly and easily back up my stuff gives me, you know, just a bit more security, knowing that I won't lose my data even if some kind of emergency happened. But of course, this isn't the only approach to backing up. Personally, I just chose that because, well, it's a lot of space and it's very fast. But of course, you can also back up your stuff to Dropbox or Google Drive. I mean, really, that's where it's safest because if information goes into the cloud, it stays there. I mean, there isn't a real likelihood of all of Google's servers just going down at the same time. Not saying it's impossible, just saying it's probably not going to happen. Which is why that is another option. But then you'll have to deal with the slow upload speed. At any rate, there's nothing telling you you can't do both, which is why if you're a student or any other person doing a lot of work on a computer, I recommend getting a backup disk, just to give yourself that sense of security. Of course, as an added bonus, this particular drive I have is a very light one. It's a real good example of a portable hard disk, and there were times I had to bring files of pretty large volumes to the school, and well, that's how I do it. I bring that entire hard drive along, plug it into a USB 3 port, and get going faster than anyone else. Definitely a good investment as a student, and in fact, probably also a good investment for anyone else. Alright, let's move on to the second thing. The second thing is actually a graphics tablet. Now, I realize I have to be explicit, I'm not talking about the iPad kind of tablet, I'm talking about a graphics tablet. You know, the kind that is a giant black panel and you have this pen and you can use it to write stuff and that stuff shows up on your computer screen. So yeah, it's a computer peripheral, you do need a computer to use it. But if you remember another one of my Let's Chat videos, I was talking about going paperless. Well, this semester, I took it to a whole different level. Even for things like tutorials, you know, stuff that you normally need to print out and then do it on a paper, what I do is I'm doing that on my computer as well, using my graphics tablet. What this means is essentially everything I've done this semester, including things that need me to actually write down stuff, have been done on a computer. There are obvious advantages and disadvantages to doing your homework this way. Obviously, the disadvantage is you need a computer. Personally, it's okay for me because I've always been doing my homework at home instead of at school, which I don't bring my laptop to as much as I can. The advantages of this, of course, are the fact that electronic ink is easier to manipulate. You can write down stuff and then select the whole lot, scale it down, move it elsewhere on the page. You know, all sorts of cool stuff like that, which of course you can't do with pen and paper. Of course, all the usual benefits of going paperless are there as well. Less weight to carry, less environmental impact, less waste of ink and paper, you know, all that usual stuff. Honestly, a new benefit with going paperless is also the ease of organizing stuff. You just put stuff into folders on your desktop and you know where to go every time you want to look for something. So no more rifling through an actual physical file to look for papers. This is the first semester where I really hardly use my file at all. Would I recommend this for any old student? Honestly, no. Not because it's bad in any way, but because a graphics tablet itself costs a certain amount of money. If you're thinking about going down this particular route, you probably want to consider whether or not it's worth your while to spend that amount of money. I mean, to be honest, graphics tablets have a pretty large price range. You can get some for as cheap as like $50 or so. But of course, those might be tiny and crappy. They might have a very small surface area, so what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to really cramp what you're writing into that small area. Or maybe their pens aren't very well made. For example, in my previous experience, I had a couple of pens that required batteries, and the batteries melted inside and destroyed the pen. Oh, and not to mention driver issues. For the previous tablet I owned, I found a bug, and I actually wrote into them to tell them, hey, there's this bug. And they said, okay, we'll look into this. And then a month later, they just pulled the product off the shelves. And that essentially rendered me with no support whatsoever. So yeah, that's one of the funny stories I like to tell about buying things off brand. So if you're interested in buying a graphics tablet, I recommend a good brand like Wacom. If you're interested to check out a review of the Wacom tablet I have, you can check out the annotation link that I've put on screen. My only concern for you is the price. If you're okay with the price, then I would recommend you get it. Because, well, if you're determined to go paperless, this is actually a good option. Alright, let's move on to the third and last thing I have here for you today. This one is also related to going paperless, and this is actually my tablet. So, if you're confused, in the previous segment I was talking about a graphics tablet, not the iPad-y kind of tablet. And in this segment, I'm talking about the iPad-y kind of tablet, not the graphics tablet. Yes, I know I'm supposed to be clarifying this for you, but it's getting a little bit too fun, so I'm just gonna confuse you further. No, I'm talking about my Nexus 7 2012 edition. This particular tablet is really one of the things that makes all these work together. For going paperless, that tablet actually lets me hold all my lecture notes, all my tutorials, everything in that one package. No matter how much you bring, it all still weighs the same, as opposed to a stack of papers that gets thicker and thicker. Apart from just its use as a reader, it can also be used as a pretty good entertainment device. It can also be used as a pretty good productivity device, essentially making it pretty integral to every part of my school day. When I go to school, on my way to school, it's a 1 hour plus bus ride. What I do is I put on a podcast and I listen to it using my tablet. I get to school, I get to a lecture, I load up the lecture notes on the tablet and I start taking notes and doing things like that. Maybe I have a break later. I can of course log into Google Drive and start doing some of my work on there. Then I head home and on my way back, I listen to another podcast. What this means is this tablet is really in every single bit of my school day. And that's what makes it such an important tool for a student. If you're gonna go paperless, you definitely need a device like this. Or if you have a lightweight laptop, that works too. So yeah, these are my top 3 devices that, if you're a student, you'll probably find useful. Anyway, that pretty much wraps it up for this episode of Let's Chat. If you have any comments, queries, or suggestions, do feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to check out the official Twitter account for this channel at twitter.com/0612TV. As always, I appreciate every like, favorite, and subscription you give me. But until next time, you're watching 0612TV.